I'm Gauri. I'm here today representing Gayathri and Namith Architects. We are a Bangalore-based architectural firm. We actually just completed 25 years. We primarily do work in India, but we do have a few projects abroad too that we're working on right now. We are around 60 plus strength firm. We have a small office in Delhi too because we do a lot of work here. We are into homes, hospitality. We do a few commercial projects. We also do a lot of institutional buildings. In this particular project, there were just functional requirements. The site kind of dictated everything that happened on this project. It's a fabulous site, which is almost 1.5 acres in the heart of the city, but by a lake. So really the whole design or their requirements or everything, you know, there were functional requirements and everything that was kind of just got played out in front of the lake. When we first went to see the site, it was it's all cultivated land, you know, so they were actually paddy fields. But the real beauty of the whole site is that it abuts a lake which is known as the Belandur Lake. So the site actually is almost rectangle. It is 330 feet in depth and it is 138 feet along the road and 171 feet. So we have this fabulous lake which is to the north. We do follow basic principles of something that we call Vastu. We have the main house which actually kind of sits to the southern part of the site. We do have a small guest block. So you have the access from the road over here. We have a small service block. So when somebody, you know, kind of comes in, you park or you alight over here. And we have the screen wall made out of black slate. But the slate was actually treated in a certain way. And you don't see the lake. So it's only when you enter, we have this small water court within the house. And which has a fabulous sculpture which was made by the client's friend. And then the entire house, you know, you kind of, you see the lake. So it's like a surprise element. We have a small guest block which has the home theater, a guest bedroom with a dress and a toilet and a small basement which actually was there because of site conditions. So we have a small library come gym and some services which happen there. But the main house, once you enter, you see this water court, which is double heighted. It has this skylight on top. Now the planning is essentially very much like a traditional home where you would have a central courtyard, you'll have, you know, all the functions around it. And the courtyard would allow for light and ventilation. You have the living room, which is at two levels to one side, overlooking the lake, and a glass cover. You have the dining, you know, which happens over here. And then it's a small breakfast nook, the kitchen, some services. Now, as you walk through this, the spine over here, you come to a powder room, the guest bedroom, the toilet, and all of them kind of look out into the lake. There are times when, you know, in the dining room, people sitting towards the south face the lake, it's almost like everybody is kind of fighting for those seats. We have this swimming pool. We have, you know, a lawn which happens here. And we have something called a mirror pool which happens at this point. So what it is essentially just 6 inches of water. But we kind of get a seamless, this effect of the water from the house right onto the lake. And our compound wall also over here is just frameless glass. So there are times when it's raining and people want to know if the house is getting kind of, you know, flooded by the lake. That's the effect that you have. and we have this really interesting staircase. As we move up this interesting staircase, which has this rock with the, you know, first few steps kind of sculpted out, then we have this landing which is in glass, then the rest of the staircase really is in steel, which has been clad in wood. So as you come up, the staircase also has this strip skylight which has you know, beautiful effects. We have sunlight which directly falls on this wall, which is again clad in slate. So as you come up the staircase, you kind of, you know, look into the puja room, which is on the first floor. And the puja wall is actually painted by these traditional artists who came down from Gurvayur. So they use these vegetable dyes, and you know, it's probably third generation who's doing this for us. And then you kind of walk across this bridge, and which opens out into a small balcony, which is flanked by the two children's bedrooms. Now, both the bedrooms actually have their dress and toilet to the rear of their room, so that the bedrooms look out into the lake. So this is where you have the lake. And both of them have a loft space. So the son's bedroom, he actually has his study below, and he has his loft which happens above the dress and the toilet. And he has a really interesting staircase made up of steel plate that has been folded. In the daughter's bedroom, she actually has this her study on top, and she has her bed below. So she also has a very interesting staircase. So from here you kind of go through another bridge. There's a small family space and a balcony, and this comes into the master suite. To the rear of the room we have the dress and the toilet, and we have the bedroom with a small seating area. This is the balcony, the seating area, and the bedroom. So all these spaces, you look down into the double-heighted water court, which you know, has the sculpture and the skylight above. So again, from the master suite, you have this fabulous view of the water. There are small features that we, you know, have incorporated into the design. So we have these angled windows which happen in all three toilets. And again, from here, you know, you kind of get a view of the water. So you can really see that, you know, the lake is really the champion of the design. So we have this, you know, the main door, which is quite simple, but from the inside we have this traditional lock which we procured from Kerala. So we don't actually use it as a lock, but it's a beautiful piece that we have actually fixed onto the door. And we also have this lily pond, which kind of skirts around this wall that I spoke about, which is at the entrance, to kind of screen off the lake to make it a surprise element. The powder room is actually divided into two. We have a wash area as you enter, and the basin is actually custom made for us. It's resin, it's bright red in color, and it can be lit from within. And again, here all the walls are grey with just a polish, so it really kind of stands out. Within the space, we have an enclosed powder room. And there the basin is totally different. It's a total contrast, where we have a single block of stone that has, you know, with the basin carved out, and the entire stone is carved. So the entire powder room opens out into a skylit courtyard. And where we have these slabs of stone which are upright, it's a stone we locally call chappadi in Bangalore. It's basically grey granite, and all of them have, you know, some detail to it. So the grooving over here again is done differently. It's kind of, you know, placed you know, with a little bit of a stagger. And this court also runs into the toilet, which is for the guest bedroom. So this one, the owners are actually from Mangalore, which is in Dakshin Karnataka. And from their family home, they got this hande. So the hande is basically a huge copper bowl, and you kind of fill it with water, and you heat it with firewood basically. So it's really fabulous. You know, the water also smells of wood. So it's a totally different experience. So these small elements kind of just add to the whole story.